Drake and Kanye West beef?
Yeah, bro, it's crazy. It's been all over Twitter, man.
Man, that's crazy. Who you got, Drake or Kanye?
I got Drake, man. Certified lover boy all
no,
the way.
No, Donda, Donda, Donda.
Never that.
All right, quiet on set. 3, 2, 1, action.
Welcome to Senn TV. I am Edwin Neri.
And I'm Colin Clark. On January 14th, hundreds of CPS students walked out of their classroom and traveled to protest against the Board of Education. The demonstration happened because students wanted to halt in-person classes due to the rise of COVID cases in the Chicago area. We interviewed a Senn student who participated in the walkout and found out what they had to say.
Only students know what keeps students safe.
Shy Rads, a CPS-based youth alliance largely made up of black and brown teens, were the ones to organize and lead the demonstration. At least 500 students from over 20 schools participated in the protest, citing in-school hazards such as a lack of social distancing and mask wearing. Amidst demands for better safety regulations, the Shy Rads also asked for CPS to apologize to the CTU and publicly acknowledge their mistakes. We interviewed some students who participated in the walkout to get a first-hand experience.
I think the impact, without a doubt, it clearly made an impact on CPS. The severity of it is to still be decided, because like obviously we were still in-person learning. The goal was to get us back into
remote
learning. Thank you. And the reason why we want to go into remote is because we are in a high school in a building with more than 1,000 students roaming around, and for many times throughout the day, you're not even 6 feet away from each other, you know, right? And we're like, okay, this is unfair, we should be in remote learning, but like, I guess it would be all right if everyone, I mean, I don't think it's all right, but you know, it'd be justified to put us here if everyone was in-person learning, but no, that's not the case, all right? Lori Lightfoot, first of all, got COVID. The whole mayor got COVID, which proves that no one is, you know, safe from this virus, one. And two, Lori Lightfoot's daughter is in e-learning, is in remote learning. So why is Lori Lightfoot okay with putting her own child or charter schools or private schools just putting them into remote learning, but when it comes to like public schools, you know, our schools, the families here, the students here, the teachers here, they are being put into in-person learning. This is injustice, all right? We do not deserve this. We should be in a safe environment where we have a less chance of getting COVID-19. I liked going to the walkout, the protest, because I personally, I was sitting like over there at lunch, right? I was minding my own business. Heck, I didn't even like really think that I'd be the type of person to go here. But there it is, and I'm sitting over there, and my friends are just like, oh my God, they're going to the protest, the walkout. I'm like, oh really, where are they going? Like, I thought it was like gonna be just outside of Senn. No, they were gonna walk and march all the way down to the CPS building in downtown. Now, we've had protests before, right? They have just been walkouts or sit-ins. But when I heard that we were going downtown, I knew this was serious business. So I was like, all right, every single student body, every single student matters upon the cause, every single teacher does, and I was all for it. So I walked, I marched out with my buddies, my friends. I went out there, my family, my Senn family, and I supported what is right. My thoughts upon the walkout. I'd say it was very compact. You know, we went there marching as a family, a sensational family. We got together and we went there and and we went to downtown, right? We took the trains, we went to downtown, and we were saying some very constructive and polite criticism towards Lori Lightfoot, who is the mayor of Chicago. And we were also saying some constructive and polite and kind criticism towards CPS. And there's some stuff against the CPD. I don't know where that came from, but yeah. And I feel like overall it was very productive because it got the students' voices, it got the teachers' voices out of us and onto public outreach. And yeah.
Be real, my initial thoughts were, oh, okay, I'm gonna go walk out, go home early, and then go to sleep. So at the walkout is when I decided I wasn't gonna go straight home, because I saw people rallying for the movement, which I also believed was wrong. So I decided I was gonna go to the downtown protest with them instead of going home. My initial reason for going was because I saw how corrupt CPS was and I saw the wrongdoings of the mayor at the time. So I was like, you know, I'm going to go support this because it's wrong. It was a peaceful, it was relatively peaceful. There were no incidents there. It was a large gathering of people. All with masks on for the most part that I saw. It was, like I said, it was relatively safe. And I think it was effective as well. A lot of people were really passionate about it, so.
Let's swing over to the entertainment. Colin over here and Lukas Palos are going to debate which musical artist is the true GOAT. Kanye West or Drake? Let's see what they had to say.
My name is Colin Clark. I'm supporting Kanye West. Got my all black on, Donda Donda.
My name is Lukas Paulus. I'm supporting the light skinned God himself, Drake.
So Kanye West dropped his album out before Drake. In the end of August, his label record actually dropped it out. Label record dropped it out. And Kanye West got better flow than Drake with Donda. His album is more meaningful. Like, his album is about his mom and about where he came from and how he was raised in Chicago. And a lot of people found this album impactful.
And Drake ended up using billboards to promote his album, but like telling us specific people from like specific cities who are gonna be in his album. For example, in Chicago, he ended up telling us that Dirk was gonna be on the album. Later on, he was in the song with Giveon, and it did pretty well. A few classics off of the album that I really liked were Girls Want Girls and Too Sexy. A lot of people really love that song, and it ended up helping Drake win Album of the Year as of today.
Yeah, say that you a lesbian girl, me too. Hey, girls want girls where I'm from, right? Yeah, girls want girls girls want girls where I'm from. Okay, alright, that's fine. Okay, I'm feeling too sexy to accept requests. And I'm way too sexy to go unprotected.
The songs I liked from Donda were Jail, Hurricane with The Weeknd, and Little Baby. Those were some of the songs I liked.
Take where you are. It went off the rail, had go down, down, down. This a new town, town, town. This a new 10, 10, 10. I'm going in. Here I go on a new trip. Here I go, I get two lit.
He's more influential with the clothing, with his Yeezy line, for example, with the 350s, the 380s, the 500s. It goes on, etc. And before he worked with Adidas, he had his own Yeezy line with Nike, too. And also, he works with partnership with the Gap with like jackets and stuff. He does a lot with the clothing entertainment. And nobody didn't really believe in his idea, but over time, people started to look up to his idea. When the shoe first came out, people thought his shoe was really weird. But once people put them on and said that it felt comfortable and it was fancy and fashionable, people started to get on the right trend.
And for Drake, I'll give it to you. Kanye definitely does have like the shoe game on a lock in terms of like Drake. Apart from just a few Nike collabs with Jordan, with Drake, he doesn't really have like that many shoes to like go off his own. Drake has been doing that since, not Drake, Kanye's been like starting that off since like 2016. But in terms of clothes though, I tend to disagree because OVO has been around for a long time and they do plenty of collabs, such as with Bathing Ape and a lot of other things. And I kind of argue to say, like, the designs look a lot better. Like, bro, like, I know you saw the Yeezy and, like, what, Gap? That's just a blank sweater you're paying, like, $100 for versus, like, an OVO sweater, like, actually, like, nice designs.
Yeah, but yours is just an owl with a word OVO.
And you have a blank canvas as, like, a sweater. So, hey, I don't see the hype, personally, but I can see why people would buy it, I guess.
Yeah, true.
Personal life.
Scott had a concert, and Drake came out as, like, his guest speaker. And so many people were so fantastic to see Drake. People were just starting to jump on each other just to see Drizzy Drake. And then also, Drake made this condom called Hot Spice. Hot Spice condom. Like, he thinks he's all that. He's way too sexy for himself and stuff like that.
I don't even know where I would start with Kanye. Like, it almost feels like unfair to even talk about that man's personal life and the things he's done. But, you know, great guy and all, but, you know, slavery isn't real.
I represent that, but I also represent the world. When you hear about slavery for 400 years, for 400 years, that sounds like a choice.
Well, like, that's pretty interesting. I don't know, as a black man himself, like, the random, like, tweets he be going about on Twitter sometimes, bro, like, hey, he's not okay, man. But I hope he does better for himself, because mentally, he's not all up there.
But wasn't Drake trying to shoot his shot with Kim Kardashian? With my ex?
And look at where Drake is now versus where Kanye is. Yeah, that's true. They're not together.
Yeah, that's true.
Alright, y'all, so I'm here with my boy Demetrius or whatever, and do you got a favorite artist?
Yeah.
Who?
Lil Durk.
So do you think he had the best album of 2021?
Nah, I don't think he had the best album, but his album was decent. It's like, it was alright.
So who would you say had the best now?
NBA Youngboy.
Bye. You're done.
And what's your favorite album in the 2021 year?
Amy Winehouse at the BBC. She's in an old live recording. It's really, really good.
Okay, cool.
Thank you.
Probably Red Taylor's version.
Cool.
Polo G.
The album of 2021 was NBA Youngboy.
Why?
Because, like, I feel like that was one of his best albums. Like, it was on, like, probably the first song I liked it. So I just kept going with this album.
I don't know if you valid for that one, though. Okay, Denaya, so do you have a favorite genre of music?
I'm an old soul, y'all. I'm really old. I love soul. Neo-soul is my favorite genre, really, though.
Okay, so I know you like old music, but what's your favorite album of 2021?
Favorite album of 2021. Everybody know what it is. It was definitely G Herbo, 2-5, 25. However you want to say it, it was heat.
You valid. Okay, Ms. Turner, so do you have a favorite artist?
Yeah, I do.
Who?
I love J. Cole. J. Cole is my favorite rapper.
Yeah, so do you think he had the best album of 2021?
But of course he did.
Oh, Juice WRLD.
Taylor Swift's re-releasing of Red.
Okay, cool. What about you?
What she said.
Alright, so you got a favorite rapper right now?
Yeah, G Herbo.
For sure. So you think he had the best album of 2021?
For sure.
The semester ends on January 27th, with the second semester starting on Monday, February 1st. New semester means a new start. Set good habits so you can succeed and achieve. Let's move into today's trivia question. Brought to you by Junior Senn TV member Faye Fall Odun.
Which of the Senn staff members has a car named Sasha? Is it Mr. Colin, Miss Kenny, Mr. Meadows, or Miss Ogunjimi? Guess they're right, it's Miss Meadows.
Okay, so I call my car Sasha because one of my favorite TV shows is Scrubs. And in the show, JD has a scooter, and the name of his scooter is Sasha. And so I got the car right when I was, like, really into the show, and I was like, oh, okay, I should also call my car Sasha. So that's why my car is Sasha.
Our juniors have been busy creating serious content for Senn TV. We challenge them with something new to step outside of their comfort zone. Let's check one of them out.
Please hold while this child
say cheese
washes her
say
hair.
Welcome to
Hannah's cooking show.
Hey Bulldogs, it's Amna Siwetz reporting for Senn TV. So for this video, I'm going to be helping bake a chocolate cake, specifically a flourless chocolate cake, with my older cousin. And I'm doing this for my family's Thanksgiving dessert, and I'm also doing it because I don't bake like whatsoever. This is probably gonna be like my fourth time baking in like the span of my entire lifetime. I'm also doing this because I'm not a cake person, so I'd say this is pretty out of my comfort zone. So while making this cake, I'm going to be running through the basic steps and the process of baking it, as well as, you know, waiting it out and showing the result. So let's see how I did.
A few moments later.
Can I have a hug?
Aww.
No, me. No, me.
We're here.
We are short people.
Is this the first step?
Yes. We all melt the chocolate and the butter. Then you add the egg yolks.
Fun.
So this has cooled off a little bit. Now we're gonna add egg yolk at a time. So then you take egg whites, pour these bad boys in, and you gotta let it get fluffy. Hi. I'm gonna add powdered sugar now. I like to do one spoon at a time. I have it distributed everywhere. Maybe I should grab a spoon for this. And then you essentially just fold till you get all the chocolate in there. What you're trying to do is, you're not trying to kill the fluffiness of this. You gotta go slow.
So that's it. How long do you let it cook for?
It's at 345 for 30 to 35 minutes, and you're not allowed to open the oven at all. So it's a flourless chocolate cake, hence the name flour. It helps rise because of all of the eggs that are in here. See you in 35 minutes.
And while we wait, will you watch Coco Melon?
Yeah.
Yeah. Say hi.
Yeah.
No. And yes, while we wait, we're gonna go help mommy clean up. Come on.
We're doing.
I'm cleaning up. What are you doing? Oh, you wanna see this?
Okay, bye.
Bye. Oh, it's very nice. You made it a dress?
Yeah.
Oh, you made it a dress.
Here she is in all of her glory.
Mashallah, mashallah. You're like the worst.
She's done, yay! So we're taking this cake to the dinner tomorrow where I'll actually be trying it. So see y'all tomorrow.
Many unbearable hours later.
Is it yummy?
Yeah, yummy.
Okay. Very yummy. She was right, y'all. What would you guys rate it out of 10?
10.
Hannah, is it a 10?
Yeah.
So overall, it went very smoothly. The cake was fairly easy to make. I was excited to taste it as well as have a family interaction, since family is very important to me. I have a really small family here in the US, so it's kind of nice to interact with each other and
grow our relationships with the smallest things that we're doing with each other. I would definitely love to bake more because this was very interactive.
Hey guys, it's editor Amna here. I unfortunately did not film the part where I almost burned down the entire kitchen just by melting chocolate chips and butter, in which I was then pretty much forcefully designated to be the best videographer I could ever be, while my older cousin took over the rest of the project because I was, quote unquote, her words, not mine, a threat to her new kitchen. So yes, Amna, you were very interactive. Moving on.
And obviously the end result was very rewarding. So that's all I have today for flourless chocolate cake. Thanks, and let's send it back to our anchors.
All the sports teams have faced adversity, such as COVID and games being canceled. But the Bulldogs were determined to finish the season, no matter the circumstances. They champed with a successful season.
Even though the Bulldogs had a rocky basketball season with a record of 5-8, the Bulldogs have come through in their last couple of games, such as McCutcheon College Prep and Chicago Subway.
Also, due to the hard work and efforts of our athletes, we thought it would be a heartwarming idea to shine light on some of them. To do this, we created a Google form asking who you think is the athlete of the year.
After gathering the votes, we will reveal the winner in the upcoming episodes. You can find the link to our form in the description box below or in your Google Classrooms. Please fill it out. The winner will be given a prize. We'll be right back after this short break.
So what do you prefer, Christmas or Thanksgiving?
I think Christmas, just because I like giving gifts, you know. What about you?
Yeah, that's a fact. Well, I like Christmas because of the food, actually. My family, my mom be making tamales all the time for Christmas.
Low-key, yeah. Would you have those tamales? Okay, but like, real question, green or red?
You already know. I gotta go with the green, like, that's my shit right there.
That's facts.
Are you okay?
I think I'm fine. Hold on, I think it's just my allergies.
I don't know, it seems kinda weird. Ew, why is it so slimy?
I don't know,
ew.
It's like,
ew.
I think that's good.
This is why you should be wearing your mask. Or else boogers will drip down all of your face.
All right, Bulldogs, we have some more exciting news to add. On January 28th, our JRROTC program will be holding their annual military ball. We will have some of our Senn TV crew members join the fun. It's going to be packed with various clips of the event, so look forward. Until next time, toots my goots.